Could you end up having blurry vision after cataract surgery? What if you walked out of cataract surgery and saw that the world is still unclear, or even worse, it is more blurry than before the surgery? Is that a possibility? And if so, why does that happen and what can you do about it? Here, I will also discuss two potentially dangerous complications that can have severe consequences if not treated early. Stick around. Knowing these issues will not only enable you to make better choices before the surgery, but you will also learn about some potentially dangerous signs to watch for afterwards. Hi, I'm Dr. Ilan Cohen, a board-certified cataract surgeon, and I've helped tens of thousands of cataract patients achieve clear, glasses-free vision over the last 25 years. If you're planning to have a cataract surgery and you're worried about how your vision might end up, or if you already had cataract surgery and your vision is not what you expected, stick around. In this video, I'm going to reveal the top 5 real reasons your vision might be blurry after cataract surgery, breaking them down by when they occur, immediately, weeks, or even years after the surgery. And yes, we'll explore the hidden truths surgeons won't often admit. Let's get started. We're diving into the crucial factors that impact your post-operative vision, starting with what you might experience immediately after the surgery. Imagine you've just had the surgery, full of anticipation, but your vision immediately feels off. What's going on here? Why isn't it perfect, clear from the get-go? This is a common concern. The immediate causes of blurry vision often come down to two main factors: pre-existing eye conditions and the eye's natural inflammation response to surgery. First, let's talk about pre-existing eye condition. Cataract surgery is specifically designed to fix your cataracts. It's about removing the cloudy lens and restoring the clarity that was lost. But if you're battling other conditions like glaucoma or macular degeneration or diabetic eye disease, these are independent challenges. Therefore, they don't magically disappear with cataract removal. They will continue to influence and potentially limit your overall vision. This is where meticulous preoperative assessment comes in. It ensures that we don't promise unrealistic outcomes, and even more importantly, it allows us to plan for the cataract surgery ahead of time. Armed with the proper knowledge, the surgeon could plan for a different surgical technique ahead of time and even select the proper lens based on the eye's specific condition. Next, and this is entirely normal, swelling and inflammation. Every surgery, whether it's on your knee, your hip, or your eyes, involved a degree of inflammation and swelling. Your eye is responding to the procedure. When the swelling occurs inside the eye, it naturally makes your vision appear blurry. Some patients experience more, some less, and this can be influenced by factors like how advanced your cataracts were to begin with. It's vital to have this conversation with your surgeon before your procedure to set realistic expectations about your individual recovery timeline. So the takeaway here: understand your full eye health picture before the surgery and discuss expectations with your surgeon. This sets you up for a smoother recovery and avoids early surprises, transforming your expectations into a positive reality. All right, so that's the immediate post-op period. But what happens when days turn into weeks and your vision is still not where you want it? This is where many patients start to get truly worried. After the initial few days, some expect their vision to be rapidly improving and are disappointed by the blurry outcome. It's incredibly frustrating when you're told everything went perfectly, yet your world remains hazy. Most patients see a significant improvement in swelling within the first few days. So if you're a few weeks out and your vision is still hazy, what could be the issue? This is where we often see dry eyes, residual refractive errors, and macular edema or persistent corneal edema. Let's tackle these four culprits one by one. First up is the dry eyes. This is not uncommon after cataract surgery, especially if you had significant dry eyes to begin with. Eventually, most patients return to their baseline state after the surgery. Sometimes this process could take a few weeks or months to complete itself. Many ophthalmologists, including myself, treat dry eyes aggressively before and even after the surgery to make sure that the post-operative healing is quick and uneventful. Next, there's a leftover prescription. What this means is that to see perfectly, you still need glasses. This is why preoperative testing is so important. You see, that's how the surgeon knows what power lens to put in your eye during the surgery, and that determines how well you see after the surgery. Most insurance companies reimburse clinicians for only one measurement. In my offices, we use multiple biometric measurements before surgery. This is the famous principle of measure twice, cut once. In many cases, we measure not only twice, but multiple times with devices of different modalities like ultrasound and laser. This allows for a significantly more accurate outcome postoperatively. If you have a significant leftover prescription after surgery, you may need to look into a lens exchange procedure that could be done after cataract surgery and can correct this problem. I have a video that goes deeper into this subject if you're interested. There is a link in the description below. Next thing we could see during this period is macular edema. This is swelling that develops in the back part of the eye, specifically the macula, typically 4 to 8 weeks after the surgery. Unlike the initial corneal swelling in front, this requires a specific diagnosis. The good news, it's typically easily treatable with anti-inflammatory eye drops, but a prompt diagnosis and treatment is crucial. In my experience, the majority of such instances could be avoided by proper preoperative diagnosis and treatment. There are specific conditions that could raise the chances for macular swelling. If they are recognized and treated early, they can reduce the chances
for this condition.
And finally, in some patients, the swelling in the cornea can linger and necessitate another procedure for replacement of the endothelial lining of the cornea. Some individuals are at increased risk for this, which should be detected by the surgeon beforehand and thoroughly discussed with you. So, if your vision is blurry weeks after surgery, do not assume it's normal or it's all in your head. Insist on a thorough evaluation for dry eyes, leftover prescription, and macular edema. Solutions are often straightforward. We've covered the immediate aftermath and the weeks following. Let's look further down the road. What if your vision becomes blurry months or even years after your cataract surgery? Many patients are told their surgery was a permanent fix, yet they are struggling again. The most common reason for this is something called posterior capsular opacification, which many patients also know as secondary cataracts. When we remove your cataract, your new life-changing lens implant is cradled by a very thin natural capsule. This capsule is a living, breathing thing, and over time, cells on it can multiply or it can get a wrinkle, causing hazy film to develop and blur your vision. Whenever this happens, it's a pretty easy fix. We have a simple, quick laser procedure that can zap that film out of the way. It takes about a minute. You don't feel a thing and the film doesn't grow back. It's a game changer for those who experience it. If your vision blurs over time, know that a secondary cataract is highly probable and easily treated. This isn't a surgical failure. It's a biological response that we can swiftly resolve, restoring your crystal clarity. So these are the primary reasons for blurry vision. But what if I told you there are two incredibly rare but critical issues that demand immediate attention? We're talking about unforeseen complications that you absolutely need to be aware of. The kind of problems you hope you'll never face, but if you do, knowing this information could be life-saving for your vision. The first one is an infection inside the eye, specifically a condition called endophthalmitis. This is truly one of the most serious risks of any surgery. Fortunately, it's exceptionally rare, reported as about one in a few thousands. If you experience severe pain, a red eye, or a significant sudden loss of vision, you must contact your eye doctor immediately. This usually occurs within a week after the surgery, but it can also rarely happen months later. Your vision is at stake, and early action is critical. The second condition is a retinal detachment that can happen anytime after surgery, and sometimes even if you never had cataract surgery. It could be preceded by the appearance of a large number of floaters or flashes of light and can present as a sudden disturbance in the lower or upper part of the vision in the affected eye. This is sometimes described as a curtain blocking the vision. If you notice any of these symptoms, you need to see your doctor immediately. If for any reason your doctor is not available, you must go to the emergency room. Early and decisive action on your part in such a scenario can have a major impact on the final outcome. So there you have it, a comprehensive look at the common and rare reasons your vision might be blurry after cataract surgery. You now have the complete blueprint to understand what causes blurry vision after cataract surgery and how to address it. You understand that blurry vision after cataract surgery is not always normal, and there are definitive treatable causes. The key takeaway, as always, is don't try to diagnose yourself. Your vision is too important. If you're experiencing any of these symptoms, talk to your doctor immediately. Also, I want you to understand that the number one mistake you can make with your cataract surgery is the choice of your surgeon. For an even deeper dive into what separates an expert surgeon from the rest and why choosing the right surgeon is the number one factor in your outcome, watch this next video. It's the ultimate guide to finding the best cataract surgeon beyond star ratings.